for this, we go to faraway Asia Minor in the ruins of an old abandoned boat high up on a mountain and see what happens. In a land far away, there's a mountain all covered with snow. And it's there that our story began in a time long ago. As it's told in the Bible, and often repeated, the ark came to Peretz, when the waters receded, and as soon as the three sons of Noah decided, it was finally safe. They set free the creatures of every description, some of them kosher, some of them prayed,
wouldn't say all the same.
Then all of them saw, with their very own eyes, a shimmering rainbow,
what's fallen boy,
way up in the skies, and rejoiced at God's promise. No matter what sin, the heavens will never split open again. Be it stealing or slander, or murder or slaughter, that's the last time I'm flooding this planet with water that was neighing of horses and braying of asses, the popping of cork and the clinking of glasses on their
shoulders.
Not a soul yet remains, not a mouse, not a bear. Old Noah's long gone, but the ark still there. And there in that ark, by the light of the cool morning air, the Prince of Gehenna has woven a lair. And under the snow, proof the legends were right, a magical diamond still gives off its light. By the light of that gem, in the cool morning air, stands Lilith the she-devil, combing her hair. She brushes and curls it, while he lights up a smoke. After all, they're not really so different from us regular folk. It's all so routine, as she turns to inquire which sinners he's planning to toss in the fire. Who should be pummeled and who should be beaten? Who should be fried up for breakfast and eaten? Who should be pummeled and who should be beaten? Who should be sauteed in butter and eaten?